This is going to be the second video about solving equations with radicals and rational exponents. And I'm going to do one with a radical sign. So here we go. Okay, here I have the square root of 2x plus 3 equals x minus 6. Now, I can think of this two ways. I could either remember that if I take a square root and I square it, I get rid of the radical sign. Or I could convert this, if I want to something like 2x plus 3 raised to the 1/2 power. Okay, and that's going to equal x minus 6. Either way, I'm going to take the left side of the equation and square it. I'll either square the radical, which will get rid of the square root, or I'll take this 2x plus 3 to the 1/2 power and raise that to the second power, which will get rid of my 1/2. Okay, so let's do that, which means I want to square the right side as well. Okay, so the left side is going to become just 2x plus 3. Now be careful here. X minus 6 squared is like saying x minus 6 times x minus 6. In other words, I'm going to end up with x minus 6 times x minus 6, and then I'll have to figure out what that is. Okay, so let's see what we get. 2x plus 3 equals x times x is x squared, x times negative 6 is negative 6x, then I've got a negative 6 times x, which is another negative 6x, and I've got negative 6 times negative 6, which is positive 36. So, probably the easiest thing to do is going to be to move the 2x and the negative and the 3 over to the right side of the equation. So let's see what happens. I'm going to still have an x squared. I guess I'll do that whole thing. And I'm just going to write down, let's see, minus 2x. I'm trying to line things up. And minus 3. Okay, so I'm going to get 0 equals, I've only got 1x squared, so I've got this x squared. I've got a negative 6x, a negative 6x, and a negative 2x. Well, negative 6 and negative 6 is negative 12. Negative 12 and negative 2 is negative 14. And then I've got 36 minus 3, so that's going to be 33. So I've got 0 equals x squared minus 14 plus 33. What I'm going to do is put the 0 on the other side of the equation. Doesn't matter where I put it, but we're usually used to having it look like that. And then I've got to factor this, because I want to find out what x could be, and I guess I could have two different answers. So if I factor it, let's see how this is going to work. I'm going to have, I know both of my binomials are going to start with x. I want to figure out how I got that positive 33. Well, the positive 33 came from multiplying two numbers. And they both had the same sign, because it's positive 33. And then I can see they both had a negative sign, because the middle term, the negative 14, whoops, negative 14x, sorry, the negative 14 is negative. Okay, so I want two minus signs here. Now I'm thinking, how can I make 33? Well, it's either 1 times 33, which is not going to get me to negative 14, or it's 3 times 11. And negative 3 and negative 11 are negative 14. So good, there we go. Okay, so the last step is just to say that x minus 3 equals 0, and x minus 11 equals 0, and I'll add 3 to this, and find out that x could equal 3, or if I add 11 to the other equation, I'm going to find out that x could equal 11. So x equals either 3 or 11, right? So let's go back and check this, okay? Let me just clean this up because I guess my hand rubbed over it. Okay, so this is what we started with. The square root of 2x plus 3 equals x minus 4. I think I'll need another piece of paper. Okay, So the square root of 2x plus 3 equals x minus 4. And the answers I have are x equals 3 or 11. So let's see if they work. Let's try the 3 first. Well, if x equals 3, then that means I'm going to have the square root of 2 times 3 plus 3, and I want to see if that equals 3 minus 6. Okay, so I've got the square root, 2 times 3 is 6, plus 3 is 9, and I want to see if that equals 3 minus 3, which is negative 3. You can see right now it's not going to work, right? Because this is a negative number, and the square root of 9 has to be a positive number. So we can't use the 3. 3 is no good. Let's try it again and see if it works with 11. So I'm going to have the square root of 2 times 11 plus 3 and see if that equals 11 minus 6. Okay, so 2 times 11 is 22 plus 3 is 25. And 11 minus 6 is 5, and the square root of 5 is 5. So my answer, and my only answer, is x equals 11. Okay? So again, make sure you check your answers. It's really going to be important. There's at least one more I want to do, probably maybe two or three more. So once again, I'm going to follow those up in another video. Okay, see you soon.